Welcome to the, what is this, January 18th? Meeting of the Finance, Deerfield Finance Committee. We do not have minutes for the two agenda items, so we'll take those up the next time we meet.
Okay.
Along with this one. We don't have any budgets, so we're not going to do any budgets. We do have a transfer request. Wendy wants to get paid.
She's worth it.
So we have, we've got a request to transfer $10,000.
What's the second half of it for?
Second half of what?
The transfer, the 10,000. There's two items, the request. The request says, "And other..."
Contractual hours for the interim town administrator and to replenish the account for other contractual services. That's what, contractual services consultant.
Does that mean going to Boston? Does that mean going to Boston?
I think we'll have extra money. No, it means, oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. No.
No. There were other things that have been coming out of that account, the two different wage and classification studies that were done earlier this year, things like that. I have the whole list. I don't have, I hadn't planned to be here. I was working, so. It's to replenish it, and I don't believe we'll use it up, but it's out now because I've been working 33-40.
So the current, the contract extension that we signed out of reserves is zero now? You signed a contract with you?
We transferred, we put $5,000 into the account, or $6,000. Wasn't it earlier?
12 or something.
12, 15.
Was it that much?
Yeah.
In October or November.
Right, yeah.
And the plan was...
We voted that in July.
But I...
July, yeah, in July.
You know what happened. So they intended and expected there to be a town administrator on board, not me.
Right.
And I continued, we hope, we will sign a contract next week, and we plan on doing that. It's been my delay because of other things going on.
You can't...
And we will no longer be taking money from that account.
You can't go to Boston until you've signed a contract.
I'm not charging the town anything.
Doesn't matter. You can't go to Boston.
But I'm going to come back with value, so.
Okay. So the request is for 10,000. Selectmen making the request for $10,000.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any other questions on this? Bruce?
It'd be nice to have a list of what we're signing, what we're approving for, that's all. A list of...
Contracted services.
Contracted services.
And replenish the account.
Whatever account we're trying to replenish, that's all.
Yeah.
Well, it's not necessarily replenish the account so that we can pay the interim town administrator.
I think it's more than just one item.
Oh, it's, yeah, there were several different contractual things that came out of that. No, I'm sorry. At the moment, the only other things that I can think of were the studies that were done. But it's available there if we need a short notice to hire a consultant to do something. And, you know, that's where it's been, you know, for, as a yearly appropriation, a couple of those kinds of things that aren't legal or, you know, legal.
So I think a brief point, maybe I'm misspeaking here, but that 10,000 will cover the contract with you till full-time signing. And then out of that fund, there'll be a reserve in that fund there as far as this transfer.
It will bring it back to what it was at the beginning of the year.
That's what I was asking.
And we may or may not draw upon it, but I'm not certain what the other things are right now, so.
Yeah, when I look at the selectmen's totals, there's nothing in the negative. The only thing that's been expensed is the Boston expense, and that's 100%.
Here's the account number. Take a look and see if...
Account number is 310. Yep. you end December. 310 is contracted services for consultants. We got a carry forward of 1,600, got an original budget of 7. We amended it for 16. We expended 15,900. We have a balance unencumbered of 686,35. Yep. And that's just the services.
Right, and I submitted a bill for 2.5 months for that, $8,500.
Okay, so it is all this one item.
But it's the...
It's contracted services.
The 15,963.50 yeah. that's been spent, there were several people who were paid out of that.
Consultants.
Yeah.
Yes,
And why the decision to pay Wendy out of the consultant? I don't know, but that was a decision that somebody made.
Okay.
That's appropriate.
Seems reasonable.
I was hired as the interim on an hourly basis.
Yeah, that's mm-hmm. why the original.
Where I was actually hired to do some projects, and then
yes.
I kind of felt.
The $16,000 was the money we put in.
Mm-hmm. And we spent 16 so far, right. And Wendy just indicated that she's.
There's another bill for 8.
Yeah, and I don't know what the 15,900. $15,99.29 that was carried forward.
So we'll have a zero balance as of with your $8,000 bill, and then we add 10. We'll carry us for a long time.
Yes, yeah, we should.
Until you sign a contract.
Yeah, right.
That's the intent.
Which I'm planning to do next.
Right. And in which case you'll go into the whichever.
Yeah, the bill is in there somewhere. Went through January 5th. So whatever time between January 25th and the 25th,
okay.
which is the our next meeting, right?
Yep.
Okay?
That's fine.
Happy to answer your question anytime. Okay. The best of all of it.
Okay. So we have a motion. We have a second. Any further discussion?
Nope.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. So the four of us, it's unanimous?
Yep.
Okay. Don't go away, Wendy. I'm going to give this to you.
He's going to give you that.
Oh.
You can have this thing.
Because it's got to go to you anyway. That way it won't get lost at his house.
Do I need to make copies right now?
No. There you go.
Okay.
Thank you.
What else? Nothing?
Nothing.
Any idea when we're going to start receiving the budgets?
They have a very small packet of budgets in so far.
That's better than nothing.
I stopped, but it's...
So what does that mean? Do we have a meeting next week, or do we hold off for 2 weeks?
No,
or
I think
do we hold off until
frankly,
you call
I
us?
Think we ought to meet next week and put some pressure on the selectmen to get the budgets.
Aren't they going to Boston this weekend?
Yes.
So that means they'll have time to review.
No.
They've got it posted for a public meeting out there for 3 days.
I know.
Well, we were at Skimmins' meeting last night. They won't have a budget until after February 16th, at the earliest February 20th.
I think we may need to ask the question why.
Yes, I agree.
I do have an updated Skimmins. Finance a report if you want to look at that.
Okay.
That's the only other thing that I've got that.
Yeah, I would like to copy that.
Let me go Xerox that.
What was our original reserve, 80,000 or 100?
80.
80, so we're down 26 now?
I believe so. Was it 12 or 16 that we voted before?
16.
16 before, right.
16.
I'm wondering if nothing else for next week, we can go through and get some of these smaller accounts approved and moved.
That's usually the first thing we do on the first.
Right, so we can just go through and clear those and get those off the table.
Usually we do that for 20 to 30 of them.
Right, yeah.
And there's no reason why we can't.
Yeah.
But somebody's just gonna make out the basic sheet and put it together so we can take it and do it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like the first one we always look at is moderator. Right. I think we have $350 in there. What's that?
Right.
$250 for a town meeting and $250 special meeting. And for years, we used to have to argue with Peter to try and get the thing up there. Because
yeah,
for years, it was $100.
Yeah, they expended an extra 50 here.
Well, they counted the special before the regular.
But I'm just wondering if that's something that we could do to at least get that off our plate.
Makes sense.
We're having trouble getting budgets completed in it.
Mm. We're having problems getting the quorum, too.
Well, the good thing is we've got a quorum tonight, but I'll bet that if Bruce could, he'd be watching us down there in Arizona right now.
He's got us on live feed.
Yes.
So it's just John and
Mary.
Mary, the only two.
Right.
Well, not here. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Yep.
So, I believe this is. I think these both have one of the warrants from January in it. So you can't just divide it, double the things that come up on it. Also, on the medical services fees, the revenues, $243,000. That's 5 months. That's through the end of November. Okay.
Yep.
Now I'll pass this one out. This is a detail.
Okay. Thank you.
And.
Thank you.
There are some of these that.
Don't make sense.
Yeah, that are tough to, you really need to have Brenda here to.
Yeah.
So you could, if you really, if you start really on the second page. And with the. Because I'm not sure what those first five or six items are.
Some of those don't make any sense to me because it says sewer usage fees.
Yep.
$334,000.
Yep.
That's totally irrelevant.
It's not sewer, though.
No.
No, well, that's why I say so. If anything, that means something was put into the computer wrong to have, you know, garbage in, garbage out.
Well, the
334 is the same. It's the same as item. It's on the next page, top of the next page.
Right.
It's the same 334,660.
Yeah.
It is deferred. That's what they had at the end of retained earnings. Is that what that is?
The retained earnings surplus reserves, which is on the second page.
Yeah. 517?
517,405.
Yep.
And I really didn't get a chance to go through these. This was with Brenda.
Yeah, the 300 was the ambulance and 45 was for medical.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, the ambulance is 300, 45 is medical, but the ambulance is $300,074 probably.
Well, whatever it is, the 345,000.
Yeah.
Is what they voted to take out of, or what was taken out of
every year,
the surplus,
yep,
retained earnings.
No, that was the capital items that they had.
It's
on
the
their
capital
budget.
Items, right? So there is a grand total of 517,000.
Yeah, and there was a discussion last night about that, brief discussion. 2 weeks ago, they discussed how they might spend that money. There was three options. Some put more away for the truck, medical expenses. The second, give back to the town. And I think the third was for purchase of office equipment and supplies for the new building.
Why would they want to put that in? Because they're not going to move in there until next year.
Right. But they were going to hold out reserve money for that. So, but they were talking 300,000 2 weeks ago. This
right.
Number 500,000 has never been mentioned. Last meeting, Zach stated that he thought that the result of the meeting, prior meeting, was that it was all going to be given back to the town. But he was talking 300-something thousand. So.
That was an option, right?
That was one of the options on the table, but there was no vote, no discussion. And again, no vote, no discussion last night. So that money typically might end up going back to the towns. And that's half the budget.
Yeah, when they come in for their budget, that'll be a big question. For the budget review.
In any event, there's some of the stuff that I don't think.
Right, we don't even need to know about.
Some of the, we don't need to know about.
No.
So.
There was one thing.
Ones that, if you start on page five, where you've got SCEM's director's salary, that's basically where the expenses start.
Yep. It was mentioned last night that that review of his increase is still in plan at the personnel committee for review.
I don't know where it is.
It is.
Yeah, that's what they mentioned, that it was still sitting in Deerfield here as far as a review of, for the personnel committee, and it hasn't been approved yet at this time.
What was the thinking on that? How much are they trying to give him?
I initially thought 10, but I haven't seen anything in writing.
10 on top of the 70?
Yes.
That's what they had.
So they think money still grows on trees then?
And they were.
That's my only problem with SCEMs. I don't have a problem with the job they're doing, I have a problem with them throwing money around and playing Santa Claus and thinking that money grows on trees. Well, it doesn't. And that's irresponsible to think that a guy's making 70, you're gonna give him a $10,000 raise for what?
Of course.
For what? He's got an assistant director and he has a third person who does all the scheduling for him. He doesn't even do the scheduling, so what's he do?
They're gonna hire, potentially hire EMS slash clerk.
They had talked about that.
You've got, whatever it is, 8, 9 full-time people, including the director. Take the director out and the other EMTs, whether they're paramedics or basics. Essentially, you're working 8-hour shifts. And on average, they're doing roughly 3 calls a day.
Less than 3 calls a day.
Each one is 2 hours.
And more calls.
So it's give or take. Out of an 8-hour shift, you're taking 2 hours. So you've got people that are available, essentially, most people are available on average 6 hours per day to do other things.
Yep.
I'm not sure why we need to have additional.
Carolyn brought it up as an option to reduce overtime. The new hire just started to make the 8th person, 8th full-time paramedic, and now they're back on to eliminating overtime for hired staff, but on-call staff is filling up the difference.
Well, that was the intent, was the on-call staff would fill
in.
And
that's what's happening as of last night's this meeting. Mm-hmm. Zach, in his report, said this is what has started.
They'd be able to cut down on the overtime.
There'd be no overtime.
Basically, no overtime, right.
But they wouldn't need overtime. They don't need overtime to do the
standard 3 shifts?
Yeah.
Well, when they added the one person to the call shift, that.
Or, I'm sorry, they don't need overtime to do the administrative work. That's what I was getting
no,
at.
No, I agree.
It would not seem that they would need it.
But there was a number put out last night of $15,000.
Right.
For EMT slash clerk. And it sounded like that the full-time staff would take up the difference in what the clerking needs were. Is that? Because it would have been much, much more money to hire just a clerk.
That's basically how I understood it.
Yeah.
I say when Zach comes in with his budget, I think we can ask some more specific questions.
Yeah, I don't know if it's going to happen or not.
Right.
It was Carolyn's suggestion, so they would not have overtime for the personnel, full-time personnel.
I think there's still some question about the software they purchased, too, for scheduling. And payroll. I think they're still trying to implement that, was my understanding. Is that correct, Bruce?
I didn't hear that, but that's possibly true.
Yeah, that was, I think, 2 weeks ago they brought that up, discussed that, so.
It doesn't look like they break out overtime.
They just have warrants.
Yeah.
Every 2 weeks showing several thousands of dollars, so.
I think staff can provide that.
They can provide that. You've got to ask for it.
Just have to ask for it.
I think it would make sense that we have a separate line for overtime. We do have a little bit of a problem with vehicle repairs.
Yeah, and they discussed that last night too, in quite, in a lot of detail relative to the newest ambulance. There seems to be a hydraulic fluid problem that pressure builds up and makes one of the hydraulic hoses come off. And they thought that they had it resolved. And it just happened again. So this is the third time, so. And I guess it's inherent with that vehicle that this hydraulic, it's been hydraulic pressure issue has been from day one.
This is the
International.
Navistar. International? Yeah. And I don't see anybody buying those anymore.
No. They're buying a Ford 550 or
350? 550s mostly. They have 450s, but I'm not sure that the 550s.
It's a diesel, I think. That'll be here in March, what we heard last time.
I still have, and I guess we need to ask, insurance items? Vehicle insurance?
All the vehicles, that was a discussion last night too. All the vehicles currently, all the vehicles by the memorandum of understanding that they're supposed to be owned by Deerfield. The Sunderland and Whately ambulance currently are not been transferred in title to Deerfield. So if we're paying insurance on those two, we're paying insurance on vehicles we don't own.
But we've only paid $471.
Well, that's probably just, well, I don't know.
And it seemed like last year it was something like that.
That's pretty cheap.
And we've got liability insurance, and we didn't spend any liability insurance last year either.
They're covered under town?
I don't know.
It must be. And they don't hit this line item. We have town insurance for vehicles, and we have liability insurance for employees. So I think maybe there's no need for those two line items. That would be something Brenda could tell us.
Another question.
Looks like they're gonna need some money for a phone now. Phone bill's real high. They did say that there are, when they do an intercept, or if they do a call for another, like Northampton Fire Rescue, don't they get paid for that?
Mm-hmm.
Is that going to the general revenue, like?
It should be going to this first
column.
This account, right.
So that would be interesting to see what revenues actually go into that account. Other than the total. Because Comstar, actually,
It probably goes into Comstar first.
But that's for the patient. You think it might go in that way too for the towns?
Yes. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised.
Okay.
Your communication systems also is going to see a large increase.
Yeah, what did they say, 40%? 46%?
Yeah, I think they said 40.
Going from $5,000 to $7,000?
Right.
Something like that? That's going to be a new fee?
And that's just because they're updating all the time. That's more or less out of their control.
Under 4240, other fees, ending balance. We've carried it 410 for two or three years, which is, isn't it money we didn't collect when we were Deerfield EMS?
That should not be on here.
Why would it be a negative 410,000 balance forward?
Let's see, which line item are you talking
4240.
What page?
Page two on the bottom, medical services fee.
As I understand it.
It says FY16 skims revenue. That's what they were in last year? They were deficit last year?
No, I think they put that in as a pencil entry.
That's their anticipated, I believe that's their anticipated revenue.
Revenue, yeah.
Okay. Is that normal to put it in that way?
Yes. With a negative?
Negative?
Don't ask me.
I don't know. It didn't make much sense to me.
Well, you no. It's
why would you even need to put an anticipated revenue in just for the budget?
Government politics like that they usually work in reverse.
Well,
so if you budget a figure,
right,
they put those figures in, and those are negative figures that they put in.
Gotcha.
And
so you work against the negative until it becomes positive. Right.
Yeah, it's really just an accounting.
Yeah. Okay. Because it looks good.
So. If I'm reading this correctly, they're anticipating $410,000
in
revenues.
And they already got $243,000.
Deerfield is going to pay $314,000 plus change. Sunderland, $191,000. Waitley, $100,000. And there are some other items in there, but if you add them up, it comes to the 1,100,000 and some odd thousand mark.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, the software's a little difficult.
Which one was that?
If you go off this one here, it's a little easier to
understand. Oh, yeah, I got it. This one. I see it now.
These should be the totals at the bottom of the...
Yeah, it's $5,000 and... Spend almost all of it. Oxygen was going up too. Wasn't there a discussion on oxygen last night?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it was any dollar value though. I think it was just a discussion.
No, they just said it was going to be going up. Plus also they have to sign off. Doctor's physician has to sign off. That was one of the issues.
I think that was it. Yeah, I think that was the discussion.
If they administered it, right. Before they could clear the hospital, you would have to get the physician to sign off on it.
So I really think that they have a budget. I think they're waiting for, at least the last two meetings, they said they're waiting for Barbara to give them numbers on.
She hasn't gotten the numbers yet from Franklin County.
Franklin County. That's what she said.
Retirement.
So they're waiting on that. But I think the rest of the budget, I think it's close.
Anything else here? Right? I have a question for you. If you look at this one page of this report, it says SCEMS ambulance, $285,000, expended $66,000. What's the $66,000 expenditure?
It's going to be deposit. You think?
Don't know.
That I don't know either.
Yeah.
I would bet that's a deposit.
That's what I'm thinking too. Is it any percentage?
It may well be.
Do we know?
70, until.
With the professional education and training?
It's about 20%.
With the professional education and training on page two there, top of the line of the single sheet.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Balance $17,400 and that, and expended $15,000.
I have no idea.
I think they discussed it 2 weeks ago.
Right.
Most of the training was done, and they had a lot of people that recert with this year.
Right.
They're trying to do half and half of the way, but I think.
Right. So they offset.
But they didn't offset this year.
Right.
So a lot of them got recert, so we might not see much next year.
My only question with that is, do we have any type of clawback clause in there?
No.
You know, if we're spending money for the training, and I realize, you know, they're putting in a lot of time and energy in this with all the certifications they have to have. But if we're paying for them, I guess what it comes down to is if they come in, work a year, we pay for the training, and then they leave and go someplace else. Do we get stuck with a bill for the training and not get the benefit?
Yes.
And
unless we have a clawback on their contract, and I don't know what they have for agreeable contracts.
Uniforms are the same way. Another $10,000 there.
Right.
I know at one time the town used to have it with the police department that if they would leave the job, they'd expect so much service out of them. And if they left anything before that, they had to pay for all the fees to go to the police academy.
Just wondering if that's something to pursue or not.
Well,
it's worth the ask.
Well, the only expenditure out of that account is one. It's a one-shot $15,000 expenditure in August.
Right. Oh, that
so,
was. The,
to Community 9/11 Training Incorporated.
Yeah. So they probably went through all the training in the buildings when it was done. It's my guess. You can't, well, they can train that many people in 1 month for that $15,000. So we can ask.
Yeah, it's because, you know, it's obviously a, compared to the entire budget, it's a small item, but I just have a hard time paying for training, expecting people to stay, and then all of a sudden disappear after a brief period of time.
So what do you call that if they...
Clawback.
Clawback?
C-L-A-W. Clawback.
So if we have to see if it's in their contract? Does the police have one, you know, Chad?
They used to have one. I don't know if they still have one or not. I've been out of it for a few years.
We can ask both.
You can ask the chief when he comes in.
Yep, we can ask them both.
Any more questions?
As far as next meeting, is there any way that on some of the smaller budget items like we've done in the past,
That's what we had planned for today.
They
aren't there.
Not there.
Okay.
And if they're not there, then the question is, what's the holdup?
Why? It kind of puts us behind the eight ball here as far as a committee, as far as trying to get.
Yeah, and what it does is it jams everything into.
Right.
you know, four, try to do four or five meetings and some of the bigger budgets that we can't do.
Right.
I don't know, I didn't give anyone a call to see what the status of the CPA.
Okay.
What they were anticipating for spending this year, but I will do that this week, or first part of next week, whatever, so we have it. So do we want to meet next week?
It's up to you.
I
don't mind meeting, but I'd like to accomplish something if I could.
No, I agree.
That's my only problem.
And the selectmen are gone?
They're gone this weekend, but the question is, are they going to turn that over to somebody so that we would have it for next week?
They're not doing anything as far as the budgets go in Boston.
I wouldn't want to meet them.
Okay. They did a couple of years ago, I think.
They don't have the information.
They've actually made the statement on one of the meetings that was the purpose of having a breakfast and posting it.
Why don't we do this? Let's leave this on call. You call the meeting when you know we got something to work on. If we got nothing to work on, there's no sense coming in here looking at each other.
Well, what I can do is I can set the...
We can post them.
Post the meeting, and then if we don't have anything, we'll just cancel it.
Just post the next three.
No, I'll cancel it that way.
Yep. If we need it, we get one.
Then post them.
Are we going to try to do a weekly?
I would like to.
Weekly or Tuesday or Wednesday?
Every Tuesday?
Tuesday or Wednesday. I don't care, frankly. Anybody?
Last year we had Tuesdays. Tuesdays we've had for several years now.
Tuesdays we used to do, we've done it for a number of years.
Yeah.
Tuesdays are fine with me. I'll just miss one.
Let's do next Tuesday, 7:00?
7:00 for the 24th.
Yeah, and if there's a problem, I'll get back to you.
24th, 31st, miss the 7th, but not all of it. I have a public hearing in November.
When?
7th, which is three meetings from now. So that's fine.
No, I do.
But that's at 7, 6:30, so I should be able to be back here by 7:30.
So 18, 17, 24th.
Yep.
And I do know the select board, their meetings are bouncing back and forth a little bit between Tuesdays and Wednesdays. So
yep.
I think the majority of them are being planned for Wednesday, though, I believe, if I remember correctly.
I think that's just that.
Sounds good.
Motion to adjourn.
Moved. Is there a second?
Second.
To adjourn?
To adjourn, yeah.
Third.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.